And the shot is rape, first degree, criminal sexual act, first degree, rape, third degree.
Three sworn affidavit. Counsel, your appearance for the record, please.
Benjamin Brathman, 767 3rd Avenue for Mr. Weinstein, who is present in court, Your Honor.
Joe Maluzzi for the people. Good morning, Your Honor.
Good morning.
People are filing felony grand jury notice and a reserving identification notice. Your Honor, the defendant is before the court charged with two violent B felonies for two separate forcible sexual assaults against two different women. The charges here today are a result of months of investigation and deliberate analysis of the evidence and the law. That investigation revealed that this defendant used his position, money, and power to lure young women into situations where he was able to violate them sexually. Our investigation is ongoing, and we have encouraged other survivors to come forward. We have agreed, with your honor's permission, to the following bail package. The defendant is to post $1 million cash or $10 million bond alternative. He is being fitted for a monitoring device paid for by him, which enables him to be tracked 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, with the court and the people able to request his whereabouts at any given moment. Although the equipment will enable him, it enables to track him anywhere in the United States, under the terms of this agreement, he will be allowed only to travel in New York State and Connecticut. If he wishes to go to another state, he must request permission from the court and the people in advance. He is also surrendering his passport and not applying for a replacement or a new one. Our case is presented to the grand jury, Your Honor. The defendant has served cross grand jury notice and has agreed, although this is not a 188 situation, that he will testify or not by next Wednesday, May 30th. Furthermore, Your Honor, we are requesting one temporary order of protection and asking, however, that the name of the victim in that order of protection will be known to the court, the people, and the defendant, but otherwise be under seal.
Well, because of the charges, it's a normal process.
Yes.
Anything else?
No, Your Honor.
Your Honor, I can't. Yes, sir. Thank you, Your Honor. Just before you
start, is there any issue
with the order of protection? No, Your Honor. I'm issuing the order of protection. I'm not stating the name of the person because what was just said. You have to stay away from the person. You can't go near the person. You can't have any contact with the person. You can't go to the home, place of business. No contact by email, phone, or fax, or any other electronic device. You violate any of the conditions in the order of protection, you're subject to arrest. Do you understand that?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead, counsel.
Your Honor, if I may, we obviously did not come here to try the case, and then in lieu of Ms. Lucy's statement, I just want to briefly indicate that Mr. Weinstein and his counsel have been aware of this investigation for many months. We have had meetings with the district attorney's office, and this morning, Mr. Weinstein, per agreement with the district attorney's office, voluntarily surrendered to the first precinct, the conditions of bail have been negotiated in advance, hopefully to avoid any controversy this morning, and Your Honor, subject to Your Honor's approval, the defendant has provided me with his only passport, which I'm handing over to the district attorney's office, and wanted to do so on the record. I will have a deposit in the clerk of the court this morning, a check for $1 million pursuant to their instructions. It is a cashier's check drawn on a Chase account, which is what they requested. In addition, Your Honor, the defendant has agreed to the GPS monitoring for the state of New York and the state of Connecticut, and we consent to the order of protection. I would also indicate that we have also agreed to sign a waiver of extradition in the event that the defendant is in Connecticut and is required to appear in New York and does not do so voluntarily. He will not require the district attorney's office to extradite him, but will appear voluntarily, and we have waived the extradition. I'm providing the district attorney's office with
copy of the
affidavit. Was that an extradition just for Connecticut or for the entire?
No, this extradition actually, Your Honor, indicates that the defendant agrees to waive extradition in any state or country should he be required to be in New York to answer to these charges.
That's correct.
It is signed by the defendant and his counsel. I will sign it and provide Mr. Brockman with a copy.
Anything else, Counselor?
No, Your Honor, the defendant understands that if he were to require travel to any jurisdiction besides New York State or Connecticut, that he would have to do so either on consent of the district attorney's office or with the court's approval. There is nothing else. Your Honor, we've agreed to GPS monitoring. The person who is coming to this park with the actual piece of hardware has texted me a couple minutes ago that he is a few minutes away in traffic.
We understand that. We have to process the check also. So hopefully when that's done and the person's here, it will happen at the same time and then fine can be released.
Can I ask that the defendant be kept up here in the interim?
Well, I believe that's going to be the case. It's up to the court officers. That's more of a security issue than anything else.
They told me, unless Your Honor has a...
I don't have an objection.
Thank you very much. Your Honor, one other issue. I served the 19050 notice. Ms. Salusi is correct. They've advised me that Wednesday is the day. In light of the fact that there may be an issue concerning additional information, we were going to file a brief with Judge Burke on the issue. I assume the issue is resolved. If it's not, once I've reviewed the complaint, I will alert Ms. Salusi and then notify Judge Burke as well, who I understand is supervising the grand jury.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Judge.
Right. This case is being adjourned to Part F. How is it July 30th?
Part F, July 30th?
Yes.
All right, bail's $10,000 bond or $1,000, sorry, $10 million. $10 million. Bond over $1 million cash. There's a bracelet that we put on the defendant. He's already turned over his passport and has agreed not to apply for a new one. There's an extradition agreement that's been approved. There's an order of protection, and the defendant is allowed to go to Connecticut and New York only without the court and the DA's permission. Case is adjourned. I'm signing the order of protection.
Thank you, Your Honor. We also would ask you to sign the waiver of extradition.
Hand it up and I'll sign it.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Folks, this is a problem with